Welcome everyone to a game between Core versus Perfect here on Tal'Darim Altar. I'll be your shoutcaster, Crota. Trying to change up my intro just a little bit. Let me know what you guys think. Anyways, Core spawning as the red Zerg player at the 10 o'clock position. Meanwhile, Perfect spawning here as the blue Protoss player at the 2 o'clock position. Core, if you don't know, is the American account for Phoenix Werra, or perhaps even a shared account, as Core is currently the red Zerg player over here at the 10 o'clock position. And this is Tal'Darim Altar, and if I did not mention it already, you know, changing up my intro just, you know, makes me forget what to say sometimes. Anyways, Perfect now setting up a pylon here on the low, or I'm right by the natural expansion over here, not on the low ground, as there is not a ramp leading out from your main base. Meanwhile, over here, we'll see what Core tries to do. Core currently getting up an Overlord. Looks like he may be going for, yeah, using that extractor trick, getting into 11 over 10 food in just a moment. And now we'll see if he tries to go for an early hatchery or if he goes for extractor pool. Both options are very viable on this map. Extractor pool generally very, very strong just to try to punish an over-aggressively expanding Protoss player. A lot of Protoss players, they try to go for a Nexus first here on Tal'Darim Altar, but what ends up usually happening if you do go Nexus first is that your Zerg opponent just takes up a third base a little bit more quickly. They can either try to take this third base here or this third base here, depending on where you have spawned. These rocks are very difficult to take down, as it does have 3 armor, so Zerglings have a very difficult time trying to take them down. And it looks like Perfect will be going for a fast Nexus. I happen to talk to Perfect quite often, and Perfect did tell me that he watches all of my Protoss games, so we'll see if he actually watches this game as well, as for some reason now, grabbing some minerals, should be warping in a forge in just a moment. There it is, and now perhaps I'm warping in a gateway as well. One of the tricks I've also seen on this map is that cannon rushes are very popular just because of that scouting probe, but it doesn't look like there's going to be a cannon rush at all. You can see Perfect sitting at 17 over 18 food right now, slowing down his probe production. He will need to get an additional pylon. There it is. Also getting an assimilator, and he should be getting a probe now and waiting for that one pylon there. So a very tight build order there. I'm slowing down his probe production. He is a little bit behind in harvesters, but it shouldn't be too bad in just a moment. Oh, it looks like units are being trained. Yeah, one queen and 6 zerglings. The photon cannon should be up without an issue. Most likely a cybernex were going to be added here, and then those zerglings will not be able to get any serious damage at all. Zerglings already trying to funnel down. They will quickly be able to intercept the probe, so Perfect will be playing in the dark for a little while longer. Meanwhile, the cybernex core needs to get added in so that those zerglings are not going to be able to run by. And there it is. The Zerglings going to try to sneak by here. The probe just going to sit there, perhaps warp in a pylon and cancel consistently, enabling it to be able to just fend off the attack. You can also see a Zealot trying to be trained. Not quite sure where the rally point was. There goes. The rally point now being set up in the proper location. As I believe the probe, was it able to actually see? Yes, it was able to see the hatchery, but nothing else. We are going into extractor pool. The speedlings nearly completed. So those speedlings are going to be able to put a little bit of pressure, but not much on Perfect. Perfect having this front door seal here, and now you can see the Zerglings are trying to peck away at these destructible rocks. It will take quite a while for those Zerglings to really make their way through, as Core now going into a triple hatchery play, and right before, even well before the 6-minute mark in this game. So what this will allow him to do is allow him to get a lot of drones. He will be able to power drone much more quickly, and also be able to save those larvae for the Zerglings. Zerglings have a very, very strong, dominant map presence. If you did not know, they're able to just cover so much of the map. Zerglings hanging out at the Zelnaga watchtowers, revealing so much information and sight, as we are now sitting on 20 drones compared to 31 probes. But Core definitely in this for the long run, trying to get as many queens as possible, most likely, and then just trying to just power drone his way through. The Zerglings about 60% of the way through taking down those rocks, as we are now going into higher gas play. Production wise, you could see 8 drones being trained. We are now finally going into a robotics facility, and the early portion of this game is not going to see much action at all. With the robotics facility down and only one gateway, we're not going to see that many units trying to push their way out. We are getting the warp gate research, a second pylon now warping in as well, in addition to another photon cannon. Perfect most likely is just slowly training up sentries, allowing those sentries to gain as much energy as possible, storing them in their, I guess, energy matrices. As core, interestingly enough, only has one queen out, running three hatcheries off of one queen. Perhaps he knows that he doesn't quite have enough minerals to be able to continue to spawn larvae, and just waiting and waiting, and we should be getting another queen there. There you go. He will be able to train up 30 larvae a minute on average. And when you think about that, that means off of three hatcheries, you can train 60 food worth of roaches, 60 food worth of hydras, assuming you have enough resources for that. Or more impressively, what 180 food worth of ultralisks just based upon your larva, if that's actually possible. Another hatchery now coming into play over here, or another queen coming into play, as this set of destructible rocks finally taken down, and the Zergians will be coming out in swarm. You can see the amount of gas that's coming into play though, so perfect, sitting on a large amount of sentries. The observer now finally making its way out. We are upgrading into a warp gate, but this is going to be an issue. These Zerglings should be able to perhaps contain Perfect inside his base for quite some time. And Perfect will be forced to run off of one base play for a little while longer. The Photon Cannon's able to take down one Zergling, but not much of anything else, as we are now seeing 43 drones compared to 51 probes, but we are getting 5 more drones continuing to be powered up still. So we are getting one Spore Crawler at each of the locations just in case there's any Void Ray or Phoenix play. And very, very beneficial there, as now Core trying to make his way out with this Overlord, or Phoenix trying to make his way out with that one Overlord, unable to do so. But he was able to see the Robotics Bay. We should be seeing a Spire after that we see the tech to the layer, as we are going to have that Robotics Bay researching that extended thermal lance range, and that's going to be a very tight window for Perfect to try to attack. He needs to get those Robotics Bay out and get the Colossus out as quickly as possible, so it is going to be two base robotics with double robotics facilities. So we are going to be getting a lot of Zealots and perhaps a lot of Colossi, and that will definitely help out. Are we going to get another Colossus here in just a moment? He needs to warp in some additional pylons, also going into Twilight Council for Blink or perhaps even Dark Templar. So we're going to have a large amount of macro coming in from Perfect. We're currently sitting on one Colossus, two more Colossi on the way. You can see that the Sentries and the Zealots. Zealots should have the level 1 weapons upgrade in just a moment. The Twilight Council may simply be there for the level 2 weapons upgrade, as those Zerglings are going to get swiped apart. You can see that the Zerglings are now trying to get some damage in, unable to do so. The Zerglings, I do not think they were able to see any of that army, as we are now getting that level 2 weapons upgrade. So yes, the Colossi are going to be able to poke apart and get a lot of damage in. The Zealots also coming in as well, as the Zerglings trying to get some damage onto a Stalker, unable to get through the shields, as the Observer is still wandering around here. So Core in a bit of trouble. He has a much smaller army. He does have a decent economy going for him, but he's still running off of only 3 hatcheries and 2 base play. Those Spore Crawlers not doing anything at all. We are going into the Zerg level 2 and melee attacks, and also the Baneling upgrades, the movement speed upgrades. So perhaps the Banelings will be able to get a lot of damage onto those Zealots, as long as those Colossi, or sorry, the Force Fields are not placed down. You can see another base finally being taken down by Perfect, as we are now 11 minutes into this game and both sides just macroing up, hoping that the other side perhaps makes a mistake. We are going into 5 Colossi now, so 5 Colossus play, and that is going to simply cut through these Zerglings like a hot knife through butter. You can see those Colossus, 17 damage per attack, one more upgrade, and they will be able to one-shot a Zergling, and that is going to be huge. Those Zerglings not going to be able to do very much, but perhaps where Zerglings fail, Banelings will succeed. And the Colossus now making its way over here. The Colossi could walk up and down this cliff, get some damage here, as the Zerglings are now perhaps going to try to do a flank here. There are a lot of Banelings here as well. The Banelings have that movement speed upgrade, so they are now on a roll. And without the Force Fields in play, just being caught out of position there, and so much damage is dealt. And wow! Perfect completely losing the majority of his attack force there, as Core now swarming in with Zerglings. Perfect just getting caught off guard by a simple second. The Banelings sacrificing themselves for one Stalker, not really worth it, as the Colossus now making its way up that ramp. Level 2 weapons upgrade about to be completed, and now these Colossus should perhaps be able to get even more damage in. as we are now seeing a double expansion coming into play. Core establishing this hatchery here, in addition to this hatchery already here up and running production-wise, 22 drones. Wow, completely able to almost saturate a group of minerals, and but in one fell swoop of the D key and spawn Narva, as the Zerg is now trying to swarm in as well. It looks like the Colossi quickly coming in, getting a lot of damage in. It is going to be a two-prong attack. Banelings going after the sentries, taking them down. And now taking down also the Forge as well, but the level 2 weapons upgrade already completed there. Taking a look at the losses, perfect, very far behind now. And army-wise, he still is ahead, but income-wise, 82 harvesters compared to 59. Total worker kills, no one has got any worker kills just quite yet. More banelings coming in from Core. And Core at this stage has only trained Zerglings and Banelings. No Mutalis. I don't see any additional production buildings or any additional tech buildings at all. Just going mass Banelings. And is he finally going into something else? Yes, finally going into an infestation pit, as the Zerglings now going to try to swarm in. But they are not going to be able to get that much damage. You can see how effective those Colossi are. Being able to swipe through, take down all of those Zerglings. Zerglings getting one-shotted. But now coming in over here, instead the Banelings now going into the mineral line here. Taking down multiple probes. We still have a decent number of probes over here, but those banelings are going to be able to catch them once again. And wow, 35 worker kills as those banelings are now just unable to find their way over here. Perfect. Very, very far behind now. Economy sitting at 45 probes now needs to be able to just continue to chrono boost out as many probes as possible. The front door was taken down. A forge now needs to be replaced, another gateway as well, but that's nothing a couple more banelings cannot take down very easily. Those banelings dealing 90 damage per attack against structures, as I believe he has a level 2 claw upgrade. So if you detonate right here, you're actually able to deal 180 damage, and which is pretty significant there. Zerglings still wandering around. You can see that one observer trying to catch up, no movement speed upgrade. Pathogen glands in addition to the ventral sacs. Right now we should be seeing some infestors coming into play as well. You can see the amount of gas currently sitting on or being sit on by Core at this time. He is not mining gas off of this base just quite yet. It is 4 base 5 hatch play, as the Zerglings just still wondering, are they going to be able to come in? No, you can see how effective those Colossi are. And wow, 5 or 6 Colossus just simply dealing so much damage. And I'm just curious as to how Core is going to try to answer against those Colossus without a Spire. Okay, a Spire finally coming into play. And we should start seeing some additional units besides Zerglings and Banelings. Those Zerglings really finding their target. And now we are getting the Gravitic boosters in order to increase the movement speed on that observer and be able to catch up with those Zerglings. We are getting one probe wandering back and forth over here. Perhaps some additional gateways should be placed down here to make sure Zerglings are unable to swarm by. And then just have this large army of Colossus, 8 Colossi, simply being able to walk up and down cliffs, take down units. We are getting that Spire up and running, but with the Stalkers and perhaps getting Blink at some point, should be able to focus down many of those Corruptors as they try to come in. The Zerglings are upgraded to 1 right now, getting the level 2 Carapace upgrades as well. So it is going to be, wow, 57 Banelings in production. Core doing a great job with those banelings, perhaps just going to try to sacrifice his way in, but the problem is that those Colossi may be able to find those banelings, and that is going to be a very, very sad day, as the Zerglings now perhaps pulling the army away, and the banelings are going to be able to come in. Banelings getting destroyed, perhaps trying to find some other targets there, taking down Colossus. Zerglings now swarming into the base over here on multiple sides, but those banelings really did not deal as much damage as Core would have liked. The Zerglings now trying to swarm in once again. 38 workers killed. And perfect. Now am coming out slightly ahead in the loss, or I guess slightly behind in the losses tab. Now sitting at 9,700 versus 10,000. And that was absolutely huge. Being able to catch and detonate all of those banelings. And now perfect once again ahead with his army. You can see almost a 9,000 resource army production-wise, though more banelings are coming into play. We are getting those Stalkers, the Blink research for those Stalkers, and level 3 weapons upgrade as well. Those Stalkers are going to be able to deal 17 damage per attack. Drones now being transferred over as well. The main bases have already been mined out by Core, as he is currently seen at Hive Tech. No upgrade to a Greater Spire yet, as we are getting some Overlords here. The Overlords, however, have absolutely nothing in them. So I'm not quite sure what they are doing over there, as we now see some Colossus now trying to make a move. The Colossus should be able to get a lot of damage into here. The Zerglings now trying to battle out. Zerglings morphing into Banelings at just the wrong place. And we may be getting a Baneling carpet bombing run straight into this location here. The Overlords trying to find their target. Stalkers and Stalkers and now Colossi now pulling away. Banelings were able to get some damage in. And wow, carpet bombing on the Colossi, taking down so many of those Stalkers there and getting just a significant amount of damage, and the resources lost both sides just exchanging armies. But perfect, now going after some of those Overlords, and now you can see 148 over 124. One of the weaknesses of trying to go Baneling carpet bombing is that your Overlords are lost, and now you can now see a lot more Overlords trying to be trained. So far, Core sitting at 2-2 upgrade, Zealot Legs almost done, as the Stalker is now pushing in by Perfect, getting a lot of damage here, and Perfect, with such a strong, strong army presence right now, should be able to just clean up the macro. Core finally getting or losing some workers in this battle and this engagement here, but Core does have a decent drone saturation here. The Stalkers, oh, Banelings simply coming in and then blinking up onto the high ground. So nicely done. Some of those Stalkers will live to fight another day, and these Stalkers are going to see the creep over here and get some easy, fresh kills on these drones. And, well, no, Perfect doesn't see this. This is a complete mistake here. Perhaps needing to take down some of those drones. Drones are going to start to get picked apart rather easily. They do have a decent amount of armor, but the Zerglings now swarming in after those Zealots. Stalkers now coming in, or Zerglings now coming in to handle those Stalkers. And corruption being cast on those Stalkers there. They do take additional damage. And this hatchery will continue to be up and running. 76 drones versus 65 probes. Army-wise, still a slight advantage, ever so slight, for Perfect at this time, as he does have a stronger gas army. Still training up two additional Colossi, as he has, what, four Colossus already. Perhaps a change in tech to Psystorm would be very beneficial right now, as the Zerglings would get taken down, and those Corruptors would have a bit of an issue. Those Corruptors need to back off the Colossus, and should be able to walk up and down this cliff, perhaps start taking down some of those hatcheries and slowing down the production. These two hatcheries very close together, and they could get easily taken down, as the Colossus, Stalkers, and Sentries now making their way forward. Creep Tumors once again trying to be reestablished. Zergling now trying to run by, but unable to do so. This pylon will not get set up, as the Zealots, and now Perfect once again coming back in with almost 5,000, 6,000 resource army, taking down the Queens. And now we are going to get Corruptors and Zerglings coming in from behind. We need to get some force fields down. Are they going to come down in time? No, they are not. Just one small opening there, as the Banelings finding their target. Stalkers all destroyed, and Perfect once again going to lose his army to the Corruptors, Zerglings, and that was just a very, very bad force field play. If those Colossi were able to actually stop those Banelings and Zerglings keeping those units alive, that would have been much, much better for Perfect at this stage. And Core still running off of a lot of bases, and I'm not sure if Core has... this may be a fun day Monday game, it almost feels like. We are only seeing Mutilus, no, not even Mutilus, Corruptors, Zerglings, and Banelings. I haven't seen another unit just quite yet, as the Zerglings now trying to find their way through, going to get a decent surround there. The Stalkers are doing that nice blink micro to get a lot of longevity and life. The Colossi now trying to pull away. The Stalkers may be able to finish off the Corruptors. No, as the Colossus now taking even more damage. Another Corruptor, or another Colossus, taken down by a Corruptor. But the Stalkers are trying to blink back in, trying to re-engage. Banelings on the move, trying to just simply make their way around the target, taking down a couple Zealots. But that's one of the issues with Banelings. A lot of the times, Zerg players will just try to move with Banelings as opposed to move and attack on a Baneling. And with that, the Stalkers were able to blink away, and the Zealots took all the damage. And the Banelings really didn't and could have dealt a lot more splash damage. The Perfect still trying to pull away once more. Banelings once again backing off, more damage being dealt. Perfect with a much larger army still. And Core, I'm not quite sure what he can do to get back into this game. Perhaps train up another unit. He is finally going to Infestors, so I'm going into three types of units. We are also getting the Zerg melee attack level 3 upgrades. I don't see a Greater Spire yet. One of the things that you should have is a Greater Spire for at least the option on Broodlords, depending on your opponent's units. Zerglings once again catching some of Perfect's units out of position, and now Perfect behind in losses. Harvester count 83 compared to 64. We need another base needs to be established, and Perfect still only running off of now one base, and he is going to have an uphill battle. Infestor is out. In comes a fungal growth, preventing any of those stalkers from blinking there. More units still warping in. Zergling now trying to find those targets once more as the Colossus cleaning up unit after unit. And Perfect just doing a great job, just trying to shut down the production of Core. But you can still see that Core is running off of essentially three base play with one more base underway. Probes could easily be transferred over. And Perfect, with sitting on level 3 weapons upgrade, just dealing the damage and able to get a lot of damage onto those Zerglings, Infestors, and Banelings pretty easily so far. Perfect does have an Observer over here. He does see that there are a couple Infestors now trying to come into play as well. The Banelings may be able to make a run for it, but the Stalkers and Colossi deciding to back off. Currently, Perfect does know about this expansion still, but he hasn't made a run for it. And that is one of the strange maneuvers, strange things so far in this matchup. I believe that he thinks that he can't make that maneuver. And no, probes, where are these probes going? They don't have anywhere that they can really mine at this stage. Perhaps some long-distance mining could come underway, but there is a Zergling sitting over here, perhaps going to get some damage onto a lot of those probes. Those probes only dealing 5 damage per attack. The Zergling also has the claw upgrade. Those probes now just doing that walk of shame very, very far. Zergling going to get one kill, perhaps even 2 or 3 kills in this group here, as it does move significantly faster. No Nexus has been warped in, and this is where Perfect is now very far behind. He cannot really engage at this time, because if he trades army, Core will just be able to rebuild his army much, much more quickly. Production wise, you see nothing as a Zergling is now coming into play once more. Zerglings trying to swarm around. The Infestors were able to get off, I believe, 1 or 2 fungal growths, but Perfect in a very, very nice position, able to take down all the Zerglings, but all the Stalkers are now gone, and the Corruptors are in trouble. The Stalkers now trying to protect those very, very expensive Colossi. 2 Colossi are left. The Stalkers, and a very nice fungal growth there, preventing any of those units from being able to move around. And now you can still see more Walk of Shame. Oh, a Baneling down in position. But that was not a good trade at all. Perhaps it should have burrowed underneath and taken down more units there. Colossus now down over here. We are getting the Neural Parasite in order to take control of those units. And now Perfect using his army advantage with those Colossus in order to shut down perhaps even more of these drones over here. He needed to do this much earlier. And it's about time that he's going to try to take down some of these drones. A lot more worker kills now coming in. The drones now desperately trying to run away. More Zerglings now getting destroyed over here. The Colossi going to be able to finish off this hatchery with little to no issue, as the probes are still wandering back and forth to continue to that long distance mining. And you can see even more long distance mining coming in over here. I do not know why Perfect has not warped in a Nexus yet. He is still behind on minerals. The Corruptors now coming in and finishing off the Colossus. So Zerglings and Banelings are being left behind. And this is where Perfect, I believe, is going to start to unravel. You can take a look at the bases. Core doesn't have very much inside his main base at all, not very much at his third base. But the fact that he has drones here and here is definitely helping out. And I think this is just one of the benefits for Core in this matchup, is the way that he has spawned. Zerglings now coming in, taking down multiple probes. Corruptors in the air, 3,400, 1,950, and Core just outlasting Perfect in this Protoss versus Zerg mirror match. And I think we are past the tipping point. I cannot imagine how Perfect can get back into this game at all. He has one Observer in his army. The rest of his food is probes. 41 probes, one Observer, as we are now going into the Greater Spire. Zerglings now once again swarming in, going to take down multiple probes. All those probes have nowhere to run. Banelings now trying to make their way in as well, but the Banelings are not going to be able to even take down one probe. Down to 12 food, 12 probes, and one Observer, and that is it. That pretty much should be the end of the game. Perfect, perhaps not realizing how far behind he truly is. He doesn't know about this expansion here, and Perfect just wondering what he can do at this point. I guess patch 135 isn't out yet. I guess he's talking about the current balance of the game. Zerglings, mass speedling play has become much, much more popular. Those speedlings, and without even the crackling upgrade, if you're going to go 3-3 Zerglings, might as well just research the crackling upgrade. And there are the adrenal glands, as those Zerglings are still wandering around. And Core saying no money. I'm guessing that he's what he's trying to say instead of not money. As another hatchery being placed down over here, so Core really taking taking half of this map, and Perfect saying that he stopped trying at some point, just not wanting to exchange army after army, and Core going a nice OMG there. We are going to get a lot of Broodlords out, and those Broodlords are just going to simply make their way out, get a lot of damage. Those Broodlords don't have any upgrades, but the Broodlings that they are launching will have full 3-3 upgrades. And that's really where the DPS of a Broodlord comes from. Broodlords are armored, biological, and massive. A very, very slow unit. A glass cannon, but very, 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 very powerful. We'll see. I would use Zerg on ladder. So just a nice conversation between the folks so far. Perfect saying that Protoss can't win for some reason, so just gotta wait for the new patch. Broodlords now making their way out here. I'm sorry I'm casting this game, Perfect. Perfect, you're a good friend, but this game was given to me by Phoenix, and Broodlords just making their way in. Mass sentries going in, and you can quickly see how fast all of those Broodlords are coming into play. It looks like, oh, a Broodlord escaping. My nerf sentries will out DPS you. Broodlord just walking around, just getting in a lot of damage, and the sentries quickly destroyed. But yeah, the Broodlords do have a base one armor there. Zerglings are going to be very, Banelings just going to be very excited to make their way and just destroy their army. You can see the Banelings are going to absolutely destroy all of these production buildings here. The Broodlords perhaps looking for this location here, or this expansion here, doesn't see it. And the Banelings just absolutely destroying everything. All right. Thanks for watching. Thanks for listening. I hope you guys enjoyed this 1v1. A 1v1 game between Perfect and Phoenix Werra or Core here on Tal'Darim Altar. My apologies out to Perfect. I do think there are some racial imbalances in the game, and that things do need to happen in order to move forward. But we'll see how and what that looks like. Thanks for watching. Thanks for listening. Hope you guys enjoyed this 1v1 game between Perfect and Core or Phoenix Werra here on Tal'Darim Altar.